Using glitch titles and transitions is a trendy futuristic method to spice up videos, especially the ones with sci-fi mood and aesthetics. So, today we're gonna try a couple of ways to make a nice glitch inside Adobe After Effects. Alright, here I have the comp and a background image of a presumably astronaut. I'm gonna create a title and begin applying the glitch from there. With the type tool selected, let's type astronaut and align it to the center. Now I'm gonna add an effect called card wipe, which is the basis of the glitch effect we want to create. Up here you can see that this effect gives us some kind of transition on the layer. And if I keyframe the in and out of the transition, this is what it does. It looks like a flip, but believe me, it can give us more than that. So let's just start by creating more rows and columns, and we get more details when transitioning. But it's too fast. Maybe I should move this one further. You can play with the card scale, which I'm okay with. And here you can specify the flip axis, which again I like the default. And the next important thing is the flip order, which gives you several options, but again I like it as it is, left to right. Now, a game changer setting in this effect is the timing randomness, which gives you the glitch look of the transition. I'll set it to 0.5, and this is the result. We can already see the distorted look on the text, but we're gonna do a lot more to make it better. Next is the position jitter, and again it helps you distort it even more in specific directions. You can see what it does if I increase all of them. Now let's bring them back to 0 and create keyframes for them to come in effect. I don't need to change the speed, only the jitter amount works for me, but you can use that too. Let's copy the beginning keyframes and make an ending for them. Then somewhere in between the transition, increase them, and it goes from nothing to jittery, back to nothing again. Now the interesting thing is that here you can set a back layer for the effect, and what it does is that it transitions the layer to another layer. So let's duplicate that text layer, delete the card wipe, change the title, bring it down, and turn it off. Then if I go back to the first text and choose the second one as the back layer, this is what happens. Nice. Next I'm gonna duplicate the first text layer and create an outline with it. So let's set the blending mode to screen and turn down the opacity to 70. Then I add the fine edges effect to the layer and invert it. Next I'll add the noise effect, make sure the use color noise box is checked, and turn it all the way up to 100. Then I add the tritone effect, set the highlights to gray and the midtones to red. And finally offset the layer by 2 frames. Look what we have. More glitch. Next, I'm gonna pre-compose the text layers and name it titles. I'll make 3 copies of it and name them R, G, B for the RGB effect. Then I add the shift channels effect to all of them. And isolate the color channel for each layer. So only red for this one, only green for this, and only blue here. Alright, now set their blending mode to screen, make sure the main title is in normal blending, then offset the RGB positions in different directions to create an RGB distorted look. So I move the red channel to the left, green channel to the top, and the blue channel to the bottom. There we go. Cool. Now I'll keyframe the in and out of their opacity so that they get visible in the middle of the transition and turn off in the end. Set the beginning to 0, copy the keyframes for the ending, and turn it up to 100 for the middle. Next I'll add an adjustment layer and name it noise overlay. Then I add the noise effect, make sure the color noise box is on, and set it to 100. Now everything is distorted. Great! What else do I want? Okay, create a mask with a noise layer around the text with the shape or pen tool. Now it looks better. Then feather the mask by 100, create in and out keyframes for the opacity, and voila, glitch distortion transition. Now if you play with the keyframes, you can set the distortion to the beginning or the end. But that's not the question. The question is, how did I create this one for the intro? I didn't talk about it, did I? Well, the pack is called Glitch Titles and Shapes, and it's awesome. Check it out. Yes, this is how you can make sci-fi glitch effects for your titles. You can go my way and create this, or the professional way and create this. If you want the professional way, check the link in the description to get your hands on PixFlow's glitch pack and glitch into the future.